Now, a comprehensive study of Australians and our waistlines has shown that we are losing the battle against diabetes and obesity. And it's not just our diets that are making us loosen our belts. It's also the fact that we don't exercise enough. And when we do, we think we've done more than we have. The Diabetes, Obesity and Lifestyle Study looked at 11,000 Australians over a period of 12 years, and it makes for some pretty sobering reading. It found that there are nearly 270 new cases of diabetes every single day. The incidence of the disease is 5 times higher among the obese and twice as high among the overweight. And there are more of us who are carrying a few too many kilograms, in particular those aged between 25 and 34, who on average porked up about 7 kilograms over the period. That is more than any other age group. And we're all putting on weight as a nation, with the average added to Australians' waistline 5.3 centimetres extra each.
People are more likely to experience depression. People are more likely to experience disability. This is an incredibly serious epidemic in this country, and it's continuing to rise. It's not declining in any way. The key thing that this points to is the need for a plan. We don't have a plan, a national plan to address this epidemic, which is one of the most serious threats to the health and productivity of our nation.
Professor Jonathan Shaw from the Baker IDI Heart and Diabetes Institute, who has just spent the past 12 years conducting this study, joins me now. Professor, we've looked through what are quite concerning statistics. What can you tell us generally that we as Australians are doing wrong?
Well, we're doing too much sitting down, like I'm doing at the moment, and we're not doing enough exercise, and we're eating the wrong sorts of food and too much of them. And the result of that is that we're growing our waistlines, we're getting fatter, and we're developing diabetes, conditions like diabetes, kidney disease, heart disease, and sometimes even cancer as a result of this.
Is it a concern the age groups that are gaining the most weight?
Well, I think it's a bit of a surprise, certainly a surprise to most people, that when we looked right across the age groups, and we did this large study of thousands of people across the country, we found that the people who were gaining weight the most rapidly were the younger adults. Most people sort of tend to associate obesity and diabetes and the like with middle-aged and older people, but the weight gain is happening most rapidly in younger adults. And that's really a bit of an opportunity, because if we know that's where it is, then that's a place in which we can intervene and try and influence the way that people are behaving.
How important is it that young adults do get a handle on it now before it becomes too difficult for them to deal with when they're older?
Well, if you leave it until you're older, which a lot of us tend to do, we put off until tomorrow things that we should be doing today. There are lots of studies that show that it's easier to just avoid weight gain than it is to try and lose weight. So putting things off until tomorrow is just making the task bigger.
Should governments take it as seriously as issues like smoking and gun control?
Well, I think that we need to, and the reason that we need to put this into the government and the sort of the regulation arena is that if we look at the areas where we've had success in health and in changing behaviour, it's been things like gun control, like smoking. We've done a fantastic job in regard to smoking in the last 30 or 40 years. There used to be 50 or 60% of the population smoking, now it's only 15%. We did it by telling people about the risks of smoking, but also by putting in a whole raft of taxation and regulation around it. And it's only when you've got that whole package that you really make a difference. If all we do is tell people that they need to take more responsibility, that they need to change their lifestyles, we're not going to solve this problem.
Isn't it going a step too far to suggest that people must stand up every few hours? I mean, doesn't it take the choice away for people, telling them what to do?
In the meantime, I think there are a number of things people can do. They can certainly be making sure that they're not spending more than an hour or so sitting down. They just need to get up for a couple of minutes and walk around. There's a benefit to that. They need to be making sure they're doing as much exercise as possible. That's, you know, your 30 minutes a day. They need to be eating healthily. And they need to be putting pressure on their representatives, on their politicians, to come up with some solutions and find ways in which we can reasonably and fairly help with a regulatory framework.
Professor Shaw, thank you for your time.
Thank you.